Hi everybody, today we are going to study types of relations. In previous lecture we have studied about Cartesian products and about relations definition. In that we have studied or we have defined a relation as if R is a relation from A to B, then it is a subset of A cross B. And it is denoted by AB belongs to R, which means that A is related to B. Okay? Or it is also denoted by A is related to B. Okay? Now, in types of relation, it will be depend upon definition of a relation. In that, first type is empty relation. Now, empty relation is defined as, if we define R be a relation from A to B, then R is called empty relation. If R set of R is equal to empty, that is R does not contain any element, any ordered pair. Okay, so then we say that it is a empty relation. Next, second type is a reflexive relation. Now, definition of reflexive is a relation R on a set A is said to be reflexive if A is related to A for all A belongs to A. That is, ordered pair A comma A belongs to R for all A belongs to A. That means, if you consider an example as A is equal to 1, 2, 3, then a set R should contain ordered pair 1, 1, 2, 2, and 3, 3. Okay? So, we can say that R is a reflexive relation on a set A. Okay? Or, for example, we can set it as R1. So, R1 is a reflexive relation. Or, if we consider an example, A is related to B if and only if 3x plus 4y is divisible by 7. Here it is 3a plus 4b here, because we have taken A is related to B. Now we have to check it is a reflexive or not. So for reflexive we will consider for any integer. Now if you consider here A comma B are belongs to Z, then we have to find or we have to check for reflexivity. If you consider A belongs to Z, then it can be written as 3a plus 4a. We are replacing B by also A only. Now here 3a plus 4a, which is a 7a, and it is divisible by 7. Okay? Because here it coefficient of A is 7. And 7 is itself divisible. Okay? So, we can say that here A is related to A. Therefore, the given relation R is reflexive. Okay? Next type of relation is a symmetric relation. In symmetric relation, if we define R as a relation on a set A, be a relation on set A, then R is said to be symmetric if ordered pair A comma B belongs to R. If order pair A comma B belongs to R, then ordered pair B comma A belongs to R for all A comma B belongs to A. Okay. If you are considering a set A, in that relation R should contain AB. If it contain AB belongs to R, then it should contain BA belongs to R. Okay. For example, if we consider a set R as order pair 1 comma 1, its A is 1, B is 1. Okay. And if A is equal to 1, 2, 3. Okay. So, here 1 comma 1, both are same. So, it is present. If there is element 1 comma 2 in R, then it should present 2 comma 1 in that set also. Okay. Next, 1 comma 3. So, there should be 3 comma 1. If you consider 2 comma 3, so there should be 3 comma 2 in that set. Then we say that relation is symmetric. Relation is symmetric. Here it is symmetric. Okay. Next, type is transitive relation. Transitive relation. Again, here let R be a relation on set A. Relation on set A. Then R is said to be transitive if A comma B belongs to R and B comma C belongs to R, then A comma C belongs to R. Okay, that is, or you may say that A is related to B and B is related to C, then we have to check whether A is related to C. Okay, so this is the definition of a transitive relation. For example, if you consider let A is equal to 1, 2, 3. In that, if you define R as a relation on ordered pair 1, 2, 1 is related to 2 and 2 is related to 3. Okay, so from this 2, here we can define 1 is related to 3. Then only it will be a transitive relation. Okay. Here we are considering A is related to B and B is related to C. So from this 2, A is related to C. 1, 3 is present in this relation R, therefore it is transitive relation. Okay. So this is a definition of a transitive relation. Next, fifth type is antisymmetric. Antisymmetric relation. In antisymmetric relation, a relation R is on a set A is said to be antisymmetric if A is related to B and B is related to A, then A is equal to B. That means, or you may also say that ordered pair A comma B belongs to R and ordered pair B comma A belongs to R, which implies that A should be equal to B. Okay. For example, if we consider A divides B and B divides A, which should be gives, it should be possible only if A is equal to B. Okay? So, then we say that it is a antisymmetric. R is antisymmetric relation. Okay? Here it is true for AB belongs to set of natural numbers. Okay? Next type of relation is inverse relation. Let R be a relation from A to B. Then relation R inverse from B to A, which is R inverse is equal to XY such that Y comma X belongs to R is called inverse relation. Is called inverse relation of R. Is called inverse relation of R. For example, if you consider A is equal to 1, 2, 3 and R contain an order pair 1, 1, 1, 2 and 2, 3. Okay? So, R inverse will be, then R inverse is equal to, here we have to inverse, so first order pair will be 1, 1 or we have to reverse the order pair. Here it is 1, 2, in R inverse it will be 2, 1. Here it is 2, 3, in R inverse it will be 3, 2. Okay? So, this is the definition of a inverse relation. Now, next it is a equivalence relation. Equivalence relation. Now, definition of an equivalence relation is let R be a relation on a set A. R be a relation on a set A. Then R is called equivalence relation. R is called equivalence relation if it is reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. Okay, so on A. That means to show the relation is equivalence relation, we must satisfy the relation should be reflexive, symmetric and transitive. If it is three of this, then it is known as equivalence relation. And last type is a partial order relation. Partial order relation is let R be a relation on a set A, then R is called partial order relation if it is reflexive, antisymmetric and transitive on A. Okay, in this partial order relation, symmetric is replaced by antisymmetric. So when a relation is reflexive, antisymmetric and transitive, then relation is known as partial order relation. Okay, so from this, which are important equivalence relation and partial order relation, and it depends on previous types of relation, which is reflexive, symmetric, antisymmetric and transitive relation. Okay, now consider the example. Let A is equal to capital N, which is defined as set of natural number. Define R on A by A related to B if and only if A less than B. Here it is given condition is A less than B for all AB belongs to N. And we have to check whether determine R is symmetric or not. Okay, this we have to check here. Now, here if we check the condition, here it is given that A is related to B. It is related only if A is less than B for all AB belongs to N. So natural number, set of natural number is 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. And definition of symmetric is A is related to B, then we have to check whether B is related to A or not. Okay. So for any condition A related to B, if we consider here, if we consider 1, 2 belongs to N. Okay. A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 2. So from this relation A related to B, we can write 1 is related to 2, that is 1 is less than 2. Okay. Here value of 1 is less than 2. But for symmetric we have to check whether B is related to A or not. Okay. But 2 is not less than 1 because value of B is 2 and value of A is 1. So 2 is not less than 1. So we can say that 2 is not related to 1. Okay. We have to draw a line from R which is not related. Okay. So 2 is not related to 1. So we can say that R is not symmetric. Or you may take any example. I have considered 1, 2. You may consider 2, 3. Okay. Or 3, 2. Here a number should be, you can't take 2, 2 belongs to N because here it is given condition 1 A less than B. So we have to take 2 numbers only. So if you consider 2, 3, 2 is less than 3, but 3 is not less than 2. So it is not a symmetric relation. Okay. And if you consider a reflexive also, for a reflexive, if we consider 1 belongs to N. Okay. So 1 is less than 1 itself. It is not. 1 is not less than 1 itself. So it is not also, R is not reflexive. Okay. Check whether it is transitive or not. For transitive, we have to consider 3 elements. If I consider 2, 3 and 4 belongs to set of natural number. Here, A is related to B. So 2 less than 3 and 3 is less than 4. Okay. 2 is less than 3 and 3 is less than 4. From these 2, we may say that 2 is less than 4. Okay. So you have to check for all natural number. Okay. So here you may say that his 2 is less than 4. It is a, or you may consider 2, 3, 4. 2 is less than 3, 5, 8. Okay. So 3 is less than 5 and 5 is less than 8. So we can say that 3 is also less than 8. From these 2, A is less than C. Okay. A is related to B and B is related to C, which implies A is related to C. Okay. So we can say that 3 is so it is R is a transitive. Okay. Here it is not, sorry, here it is not reflexive. Not a reflexive. It is not reflexive, not symmetric, but it is a transitive relation. Okay. So by using definition, you have to check the relation is reflexive, symmetric or transitive or anti-symmetric. Okay. Now consider next example. Let A be a set of lines in a plane. Set of lines in plane. Define R on A by A related to B if and only if, here a relation is related, A related to B if and only if line A is parallel to, line A is parallel to line B. okay, show that R is an equivalence relation. Okay, we have to show that the given relation is an equivalence relation. For that, we want to show that for equivalence relation, we want to show R is an reflexive first, reflexive second condition symmetric, and a third condition transitive. Okay, so on now first is a reflexive, here we have to consider A belongs to set A. That means line A is consider line A in a set of a line plane, in a plane which is defined by set A. Okay, and we have to show that line A is parallel to A, and we know the properties of a parallel line, that is that a line A in a plane is parallel to itself. That means A is related to A itself. Okay, for any line in a plane, that means for all A belongs to A. Okay, therefore R is reflexive. So by properties of a parallel lines, you can say that if you consider this as a parallel line, okay, so it is a parallel to itself. It will not coincide with itself. Okay, here it will go parallel to itself. So you cannot say that it will intersect to itself. So a line is parallel to itself and it is a reflexive relation. Okay, so for and you have to remember that for a reflexive relation you have to consider only one element from that set. Okay, now for symmetric you have to consider two elements from that set. So here a set of A is a set of lines in a plane, so you have to consider two lines, A comma B belongs to A. Let line A and line B be a lines in a plane, and as A is related to B, in symmetric it is given that A is related to B, that is line A is parallel to line B. Okay, now here line A is parallel to B, that means if we consider these two lines A and B, line A and line B, here line A is parallel to line B. And by again properties of parallel lines, you can see that, or you may here see that if A is not intersect line B or B is not intersecting line A, so you can say that B is parallel to line A also. Similarly, since line A is parallel to line B, you can say that line B is parallel to line A. Okay, so that, which means that B is related to. So from this we can say that R is an symmetric relation. Here we consider A is related to B and we are getting B is related to A. So we can say that R is an symmetric relation. Okay, so you must remember that in symmetric relation we have to consider any two elements from the given set. And in transitive relation we have to consider from the given set. Let A, B, C belongs to set A. Now here A is related to B, which implies that line A is parallel to line B. Okay, so from A is related to B, and B is related to C, which implies that line B is parallel to line C. By definition of transitive relation, Definition says that if A is related to B and B is related to C, we have to check whether A is related to C or not. Now, here, these are line A, B, and if I consider A is line parallel to B and B is parallel to line C. Okay, so these three lines are parallel to each other. So, we can say that line A is also parallel to line C. So, from these two, we can say that line A is parallel to line C. Line A is parallel to line C. That means A is related to C. Okay? So, relation. R is a reflexive, R is a symmetric, and R is a transitive relation. From this, we can say that R is an equivalence relation. Okay? Equivalence relation, which is our required solution or proof. Okay? So, from this way, we can say that it is reflexive, symmetric, or transitive, and we prove it as an equivalence relation. Okay? In next lecture, we will see more examples related to equivalence relation, partial order relation. Okay? So, for today, we will stop here. Thank you.